how do you feel about growing produce hydroponically, specifically the fertilizer that is used? You know, I have mixed feelings about hydroponic foods. The negative side of hydroponic is that you really don't get that earth resonance, that healing resonance of the earth, because the plant is deep in the soil. As long as the hydroponic systems that are growing the food are using organic or organically certified biodynamic methods, then I don't really see that much of an issue, because what we're really looking at is the energetic value of the food, the toxicity level of the food. And in all honesty, I would probably say some hydroponic, aquaponic foods that are being grown right now are cleaner than foods, even if they're organic, grown in the earth. And the reason why is because still a lot of organic farms are using tap water to water their crops. And the fact that the chemtrail spraying and all of the toxic compounds that are being released from plants and production facilities and from the planes and from everything else that's traveling in the air is also starting to settle on all of the fields. So that can be, and the contamination from the genetically modified foods as well. So that can also be a situation, and has been a situation that we've been dealing with here, trying to figure out for the last 5 or 10 years. And that's why people are going to greenhouses. And there is even talk that in the future, 10 years into the future or so, that we might be exclusively growing all of our food within greenhouses or indoors. And that's a sad thought, but the reality is our air and our soil and our water is so contaminated that it's even contaminating the organic and the biodynamic farms right now. So I think that we will also invent other types of growing methods. I think that when people realize that they really don't need to eat but maybe a quarter or an eighth of what they're currently eating, which would cut down the worldwide supply of food necessary for our bodies by 75%. We eat way, way too much. The normal pattern, if you look at years of research and fasting and intermittent fasting, is one meal a day, maybe a couple snacks. So that is a big challenge that we're dealing with right now in the world, is what are we going to do about all of the plastic residue, the hormone residue, and all this other prescription drug residue that's in the water? And what are we going to do to ensure that we can have clean food to eat in the future? So I am not against hydroponics or aquaponics or anything like that. It's still a lot of research that needs to be done, but there are ways to grow vegetables and lettuces, et cetera, and use hydroponic methods. And even now there are ways to increase and to produce and to play sound frequencies while you're doing that, so you can induce the earth frequencies or the scalar type energy fields that you might need to ensure proper growth of the plant. As a matter of fact, a guy named Dan Carlson years ago invented a device called the sonic bloom, and it basically mimics birds singing, and that is an extremely effective method to use in the fields or during growing periods indoors as well.